and try a Muslim young man and see. You don't need an imam. Go and try a normal young boy who is a Muslim. He will show you that he will do anything to defend his faith. Because they have been taught that they can't separate their life from their faith. Their faith is their life. They rather die for their faith because they've been taught that their faith is their life. And we rather carry a word, the just shall live by his faith. We still separate our faith from our profession. We separate our faith from our lives. To a believer, it's okay when we say don't go to church. You don't understand that your faith is your life. The day you understand, you will do everything and fight for your faith because that is your life. They've made us understand that our life is our profession. Our life is our career. Such a lie. Our life is not the career. Your life is not a profession. Your life is the God you believe in. That is what Christians are still struggling to understand. Turn this stone to bread. He said, man shall not live by bread alone, but by every word that proceeded out of the mouth of God. That is life. Enti Christo ni bet matne fie 6 months and fane ho. Free say, eno nye na brabo ni se obe sorry ako school. Na brabo ni se obe sorry, hey, wako diomaba. Na brabo ni se obe se, or din se eno ni a brabo. And other religions are being taught that their life is not their school. Their life is not their profession. Their life is the God they serve. And they will do everything to defend the faith that they are in. But Christians, anything we throw to us, we accept it and we go because life is not our faith. The church of old, Peter mo no muko bompae wa sorry them more 3 times every day. Omuko 9 a.m., 12 p.m., and 3 p.m. They go and pray every day in the church. And nebra sorry Friday and Sunday by the amount. Who we know be catchers and amode asorin kwana kwa asorin kwana ko no aniage. And they are the law about trying to stop even church services. No Christian is bothered. We are not bothered. We don't care. Because we don't even understand the essence of faith. We don't even know the place of faith and the place of our profession. We don't know. That is why we can't make any little sacrifice for our faith. We can't make it. This 70 years, 80 years life we are living on it. It is your faith that will determine eternity. And you are there joking with that faith. Do you know why Muslims are the richest? The way they are committed to their God. Their God cannot but bless them. The reason why Christianity is struggling is because we have separated our faith from our life. And our God is telling us, build your life and let me see. Just build that life and let me see. Those people have been able to merge their lives with their faith. Their God is helping them. You are a for and one more empire in original. And many believers, you've not even spent 30 minutes to pray, you are here. You've not spent 30 minutes to read the Bible, you are here. And it is a normal thing for you from since the January began. The only time you really pray is when you come to church. They, even in school, their students still pray 5 times a day. They have been taught that you can't separate your faith from your life. But Christians, we have not been taught. We don't understand. That is why it looks like we are not getting our God to move. We are dealing with people who are more committed to their gods than us. There are occults who have never slept 12 a.m. They've never slept because it's a commitment to their gods and their altars. They will never sleep. But a believer goes to do anything he wants and come back. You know why? Because we don't have a God. Our pastors are now our gods. So if this pastor doesn't prove himself, I'll go to another pastor. So I don't need to be committed genuinely to a God, to the God we serve. No, I'm rather moving one after the other to see the most powerful pastor. If he solves my problem for me, then I see what to do. So genuinely, we are not committed to God. We are committed to men. When other people are being taught a God that they must commit to, no fear, no shame, nothing. They are simply committed to what they are doing. And we are still fighting among ourselves. We are not even seeing. The Bible says, look unto Jesus. Yet we are not looking at him. No commitment to him. Nothing. We don't hear his voice. We are not complacent to his spirit. We don't do anything committed to him. We walk through the week and then find a church, go and drop a tithe and go. And we still say we are serving God. A God we don't know. How can we stand in the days of persecution? And today it is we ourselves that are persecuting each other. It's believers that are persecuting each other. The very people at the top. It may even be that the one that signed the final letter goes to a church. He goes to a church because he doesn't understand. He doesn't know when Jesus said, go into the world and preach the gospel. The world there means cosmos, the arrangements of the world. And this world has 7 mountains. the political mountains, the educational mountain, the religious mountain, the media mountain, and believers are to enter there to send the gospel, influence those mountains. And we don't even understand why God gives us accesses to certain glorious places. To a Christian, new ko ra ho pe, no are separating the faith from the profession. Me ra officer, me a professional, me ba sorry dema, me a Christian. That is what is happening. They don't even understand. When Jesus said go into the world, he meant go into government. Go into the government. And a believer gets into government, he forgets anything about Christianity. Monday to Friday, he's making decisions against the church. Sunday, no, I'm sorry. Because he has been taught to separate his faith from his life. So we have a lot of people in the realm of authority, but none of them is standing. They don't know that they are the doors, that through them the gospel must reach certain mountains. But they go there and they close the door to the gospel. Very soon you'll be MPs and you'll forget that you went there because of Christ and not because of contract. Many of you are CEOs and you've forgotten you are CEO because of Jesus and the gospel. There are believers with schools, Christians with schools, who do not promote Christianity in the school, but they've forgotten that they were placed in the mountain of education to influence them with the gospel. Go into the world, go to the cosmos, go to the arrangements, everywhere, when influence them with the gospel. But we go there and we forget, and we rather fight the church. Most of African presidents are Christians, but they get to the top and they forget. But when Muslim presidents get to the top, they remember that they first have a God before a seat. And the enemy is trying to swallow up the faith of Christianity, and we are not bothered. Everything coming is coming after us. Let's be watchful. Faith is not something we use to get miracles from God. It's a life we live. We have reduced the essence of faith to trying to get something from God. And every time we come to church, we don't know that this GDA is a life. The miracles are a byproduct of that life. This life is a spiritual thing. It is faith that is the engine. The God that supports you is the engine of your life. Miss that God and you'll be like a cotton moving about. You are nothing. And the devil has weighed our faith to realize that we've managed to separate our faith from our profession and our life. So we are trying to live a life somewhere. And then on weekends, we try to come and check up on our faith. And on Monday, we return back and live that life. And weekends, we try to come and check up. How is it going? Then we give a little offering, then we go. That is what some people have understood, that there is nothing you will do to them. They can afford to lose their jobs, afford to lose everything, marriage, they can afford to lose anything, but you dare not touch their faith, because they have been taught marriage is not their life, faith is their life. So you can take anything away from them, but not their life, which is their faith. And Christians are yet to get there. Apostle Paul will tell you, this life that I live is not I, but Christ that lives in me by my faith in the Son of God. So you don't sit down and be, if something is coming after the church, be bash or in so near ed near and fine, because you can see a lock sorry, young cut nephew, and yes, you bear your online church. May we understand the place of our faith.
Amen.
That we don't have any other life to live apart from the faith we have in Jesus. And we grow in that faith. We work towards that faith. We are committed to that faith. We feed on that faith. We do everything. We spend our time building that faith. That is our life. A big building on it 5 times every day in their mosque. And we come sometimes twice a week. And even that twice a week, they are now doing everything to regulate us. And we are fine. Apostle Paul will be bold to tell you that nothing shall separate us from the love of Christ. He says, shall persecution, shall perils, shall hunger, shall famine. He said nothing. He said no angel, no devil can separate us. That is the heart. Akuma, Lord, release heart of lions. Believers that nobody can separate them from their faith. Believers with understanding that you can't separate me from my faith.